I generally try to do my best to comply with all the requests that I get to do demos with certain razors or certain products. And that's the reason I was kind of disheartened and disappointed recently when somebody asked me if I could do a demo with a Feather all stainless razor. And my reply was, I'd love to, but I didn't have one. And I know they're pretty expensive. I think they're about $180 or so, between $170 and $200, somewhere in there. So it's not in the budget, holidays coming and whatnot. And much to my surprise, somebody sent me one to do a demo with. So I'm very excited to try this out. And I just want to show you that how it comes in this beautiful presentation box. It's made of wood and it has a cover that's fitted. So you just take off the cover, and then inside is the razor itself, and it's in a sponge holder, which really it snaps in place and it doesn't fall out. It's locked in there. Also comes with a package of 10 blades, Feather blades. And so you take the razor out, and it's a thing of beauty. It's got a great feel. I mean, these ridges, this knurling on the barrel, it's pointy and it's very grippy. It's just really easy to hold on to, and it's got a great feel to it. Also, if you can make that out, it says Feather across the blade compartment holder. And so that's what it looks like. And I weighed it on my digital scale. It weighs in at about 3.2 ounces. And so it's heavy enough to do the job, I think. We'll see. I've never shaved with it. This will be the first time. So I will take it apart so you can see how to load it. Just unscrew the barrel. This is a three-piece razor as opposed to some other razors that have butterfly doors. So you have three pieces. What you do is, I have a brand new blade here, Feather blade. What other blade would I use? It's a Feather razor. We're going to use the Feather blade. Slide that over the post like so. And then insert this blade guide holder over it. And then take the barrel and tighten it down like so. And it's ready to get the shave on. There you go. So let's set that down for a second. I'll brush some water on my face today because I just prepped my face, hopped out of the shower. So all I need to do is wet it up a bit. And I find that when I use the brush to wet my face, it's much easier to get the water on my neck. It's hard to get the neck, apply a proper application of water on the neck. So this way, you can just actually really rub it in there. Okay, so I have my lather mixed up. As you can see, I have a nice Uber lather. And we'll get going. I'll start applying on the left side here. Now, by the way, I have a pretty heavy, this is about a week-long beard. I just thought that to really give this feather the acid test, let's grow it out and let's see how it handles it. So I'm pretty excited to see how it works out. You just apply the lather, circular motion, like so. Just get it a nice thorough coating so that you don't see any skin showing through underneath. And that should be sufficient. Proper protection for the blade, and that will provide a nice cushion for it to glide across on your face. And paint it the last bit. Okay, let's see what happens. Set that down. Okay, so clear the runways. I like to clear off the sideburns a little bit so I can guide and make them both the same so one doesn't wind up longer than the other. So I dip the razor in the hot water, and then I'll get to shaving on the left side here. Cut the sideburn. Some people have said, just different things I've heard and read, is that this is a bit of a mild razor, which just from my first couple of strokes here, I'm not sure I agree with that because it seems to be really doing a fine job of taking my whiskers off right now with just a few strokes. So you see my heavy beard is just, it's disappearing quickly. It may not be as sharp as a slant bar, but it seems to be doing the job nicely. It has a great feel in the hand. I generally like to keep a finger underneath the barrel just for a little support. And my first pass is just a downward, north to south with the grain, like so. And I'll probably perform three passes today. Down the neckline. And I'm not expecting that this will remove my heavy beard growth in one pass. So generally, always perform three passes. And the only thing I differ on is the last pass, the third and final pass, whether I go across the grain again or against it. Generally, if I'm going for a super smooth shave, I'll go against the grain on the third pass. Okay, so there's the first pass complete. I'll do a slight rinse off. Not necessary to remove all the cream, because you're just going to apply more. So let's apply that second coat. And this second coat goes on much easier. I have a great smelling cream here. The second coat goes on easier because I've already removed that heavy duty first coat. First layer of whiskers, you know, the heavy duty beard that I started with. And you can see there's more than enough lather in my mixer to perform a good three passes with no problem. It's a nice invigorating thick lather, smells fantastic. Okay, so we'll set that down. Clear the runways again. And this time I will go across the grain, starting from the ear, going towards the nose. You just need to be a little careful going across your lip area because it's kind of sensitive over there. So you just need to exercise a little caution there. Here I go with a backhand grip on the left side. And these safety razors are nothing like your multi-blade cartridge type razor. You don't need to apply any pressure because there is no pulling or dragging. It's a super sharp blade, and it'll just shear through your whiskers cleanly. You don't have the premise of one blade pulling and the other tugging and them following each other. So now I'll go against the grain on my neck. Okay, very nice. That's the second pass complete. So I will now, again, perform a slight rinse off and I'll apply for the third pass, the third and final pass. Okay, this pass, I will start at the neck and I'll work my way up. One great thing about this razor I can say right now is the grip on it is fantastic. This knurled barrel, it's just so easy to hold on to. There's no problem whatsoever. Even with slippery or wet hands, easy to hold on to. So it's against the grain on the neck. And also you don't need to apply any heavy duty pressure as you might need to with some other razors, multi-blade cartridge types. This, you just, the weight of the razor is generally good enough to get the job done for you. So I start at the bottom working my way up like so, And now I'll go against the grain on this final pass because I'm looking for a nice smooth shave today. And this final pass, it's a cat's meow. This is the ticket as far as if you really want the baby smooth shave, this is your way to accomplish that. As you can see, very nice and smooth. And I'll use my left on this side so you can see it better. And I'll even go against the grain on my chin, which in general I don't, but well, let's do it and see how it works out. I just pull my skin down a little bit and stretch it, and that kind of helps me get a little bit closer. Oh yeah, very nice. No problem. And I go from the nose towards the ear on my lip. I don't feel the need to go against the grain on my lip with this. And then I always will just go a little extra on my chin right here. Just buff it a little bit. To hit that cleft area. Okay. I'll do the set the razor down, do a final rinse. There you have it. That's a very nice shave. And as you can see, I went from the heavy duty growth. Now I'm down to baby smooth. Very nice. I do a spot check and peel around now. And if I missed any areas, I go back in there and hit it. I see I missed a little bit right here, I think. Let me hit that. Just that corner of my chin. So I'll just buff it. That's it. So now a cold water rinse and close off the pores. Let the water run down the drain. Okay, so that's my nice close shave with the feather all stainless, and I'll give you another look at it. Rip it off a little bit. There you go, there you have it. Feather all stainless, it's got a great feel, and it looks beautiful as well. It's an engineering feat, I would say. It's just a marvel, it's a beautiful razor. And of course it won't get any water spots or rust or any problems like that because it's all stainless. So if you have the money or the funds available for a purchase, I would say it would be worthwhile for you. And again, it's not as aggressive as, say, a slant bar, but it's every bit as good as most other razors on the market as far as getting yourself a nice, clean, close shave. So I hope that helps you. If you have any other questions, I'll be more than happy to answer whatever you have, as always. And thank you for watching. We'll see you next time. Take care.